Good morning. This is Dr. TF, and I'm here in our studio IDE to give a sample program on grammar of graphics. Okay. So, grammar of graphics is nothing but we can create some kind of complex plots to visualize data in the form that we have not visualized before using a bar plot or a pie chart, and this can be done by using a function called as ggplot2. Okay, so before invoking a function, we need to install that in R. So let's go to the console window and let's install the packages ggplot2. So that's how you can install this package ggplot2, install.packages.ggplot. We already done that in the first video, so I'm not doing it again. So once you install it, we need to invoke this particular ggplot2 function. It is a grammar of graphics to visualize data. That's what the line number 1 does, okay? So look at this line number 2. You have a command called as rm. And this is a new one. So generally when you don't know about a command, what you can do is you can go to the console. You can put this question mark and you can type the command itself, okay? So you see that I put a question tag and I have made this command. So when you enter it, yes, you get the command info in the help section. Okay, you can straight away type here in the section, or you can put this statement in the command section, the console section, you can get this. So this remove and rm can be used to remove objects, nothing more than that. So they are instrumental to remove objects in a R programming. Okay, so what the thing is, we already have a object here in the global environment, so this can be removed using a broomstick or can be removed using a function like this in the source column. Okay, so let's execute this one and see what happens to the environment window. Watch, it's empty now. Got it? So that is the very reason we tried to use this particular function at the start. Okay, so that's simple. So look at the third and the fourth line, which we have seen it umpteen times before. What we do is we are trying to get moviesdata.csv, a comma separated value file from our working directory, and we are putting it into movies data frame, okay? And we are just viewing that data frame. So environment variable is created. Since the file is very large, so this is the data frame. You can see it has many kind of columns and rows, which we'll see it. Okay, so that one opens now. Okay, after this, the main discussion of this video, like we need to plot the ggplot. Okay, so after invoking this library, I don't know if I've invoked on that one, just do it again. So it's invoked right now, right? So what happens in this ggplot command? What are the arguments are there? Let's see it. The first argument is data argument, which takes the data of frame name. Okay, so movies, the data frame name, which we have read it from the moviesdata.csv file, and the kind of mapping that we are going to do equals to AES. So what's an AES? Okay, AES is nothing but what we are doing here is it's nothing but an aesthetic component here. It will give a visual property of objects that are available in the plot. Okay, so it can either include lines, points, symbol, or whatever it is. Or simple, it's used to just customize your plot, nothing more than that. Okay, so the syntax is mapping equals AES, it's common for everything, and inside that you'll give the field for X and Y. Okay, so there you are trying to give a scatter plot here in this statement 7 and 8. Okay, so you need an X and Y coordinates, and you have a critic score in one column and audience score in another column. So it will get try to give a plotting of aesthetic value of a critic score and an audience score here. Okay, then you see this syntax clearly here. There's a plus symbol here, and there is this geom underscore plot and with a function bracket. Okay, so this syntax is gonna be important when you try to give your ggplot. I'll repeat it again. Ggplot, inside you'll have a field for data which takes the data frame names, and you have a mapping field which is the aesthetic component of an x and a y coordinates plus the symbol which mandatorily must be there and the kind of ggplot that you're trying to make. Here I'm trying to make a point graph here. Okay, let's run it and see how it comes by. Yeah, this is our ggplot here. You can zoom in for extra visibility. Yeah, this is how the scatter plot is coming by for the critic score and the audience score. Now we can also give a bar chart for this ggplot. For that we have this 11 and 12 lines. It's similar to the 7 and 8th line. It takes data frame movies and the kind of mapping is it takes just an x because it's a bar graph. It only takes care of critic score. If you have a doubt, we already have seen this table. It has a column called as critic score and it does have a column called as audience score, so it takes that alone. Okay, suppose if you are having a doubt where it is trying to take. Okay, so and what it does is it's making a fill column here, fill field here, genre. Okay, so what genre you have, that will be filled along the bars for the critic score. Let me show the graph, then you will have an idea. The labs is for labels, which we already seen it for the bar and for the other graphs. For the Y, you have a rating count label, and for the title, there's the title of ggplot, you're having this count of MPEA and plus symbol, and finally GOM underscore bar will be the kind of ggplot you're trying to have here. Okay, so let's run it. So now watch carefully. So critic score is the length of the bar you have here, okay, and you can have labels, rating count along the y-axis, the title is the count of MPAA, okay, and the x-axis you have the label critic score which comes through the aesthetics here. And as I told you, the fill will be governed by genre here, the genre of the movies. It's given on the right side here. Let me zoom it, you'll get a better idea on that one. The genre of the movies is given as action, adventure, comedy, documentary, drama, horror, suspense and sci-fi. So if you can see, the action is, will be given in this this pale pink color, and the bright pink is given by this science fiction fantasy. As you can see, this shades, pale shade of pink and the light shade of pink. The drama is given in this greenish blue kind of copper sulfate color, and and the others as well. So this actually denotes the grammatical aspect of a plot. That is the very reason they call that as a grammar of graphics here, or GG in short. Okay, so as in other graphs as well, you can try to export or save this particular graph in the form of an image, PDF or to a clipboard, so that you can use it for the project of your choice. Okay, apart from saving it here, you can also save it through the source window by using this command. If you can see in statement or the line number 14, there is a gg save command which can be used to save a gg plot, and it takes the field of what file you need to save into. Yes, okay, you give a location, will be saving in that location, or by default will be saving to the default directory. Let's run this. It's asking like it's going to save in this a dimension of imaging, and it's been saved. Okay, now let's go into this our location and see if it has saved properly. Yeah, it's been saved in that PNG file. This kind of saving can be done for almost all kind of plotting that you're trying to do for an art studio. Okay, and there are number of GOM plots available. Like you can even use GOM underscore histogram to make a histogram plot of with the aesthetics and the ggplot. Okay, so that's it about ggplot and the basic functions of plotting functions of R. feel free to drop in any comments that you have in the comment section, and let me know if you have any suggestions from your side. I'll be all ears here. Thank you. Meet you in the next video. Bye.